Adam, just on Pride, whether you're a member of the queer community or an ally, how do you think everyone can get involved in Pride celebrations? And just on a personal thing, I always worry about the language I use around Pride, and I'm never quite sure if I'm getting it right.
Okay, what are you worried about? Which words? Let me. I will be a non-judgmental, warm, caring, understanding queer man here.
Where are we with the word queer as well?
Because that's an interesting one.
Because I know a lot of older gay men hate the word.
And older straight folk too always heard that word as a really terrible word.
Yeah, like a slur, wasn't it?
But for whatever reason, over the past couple decades, it's been sort of taken back by the LGBTQ community, and we use it as like an umbrella term for all of us because we kind of needed one. Like all those letters are getting, there's a lot of letters. Yeah. LGBTQIA.com.
Yeah.
You know, it's kind of like taking a word back and taking ownership of a word that used to be used against us, but using it in a positive way, in a way that encompasses everybody. It's like the family.
That makes sense.
So I think so much of language, it's so tricky, but intention is everything. And we're living in an age where it's like, you know, things are printed on, you know, an Instagram post or on Twitter, and people get very literal and they can take things out of context really quickly, but it's important to look at the context. Like, how was it said? What was the sentence it was used in? Because I think it would avoid a lot of conflict for people if they could do that.
Yeah.